this is Anthony Gill, Principal Talks with Anthony Gill, and this is Sui. And so Sui is actually from Asia. What you said, near Thailand?
Yeah,
more
near Thailand than that, under China.
Okay, all right, which is under China. Okay, so again, kind of what I do is kind of reaching out to people, and really, you know, there's a lot of people that don't actually believe in God. You know, there's the debate. You have scientists that say there's no such thing as God, and I'm very interested in the views from the eastern part of the world, where Buddha is very popular. And a lot of Buddhist people don't necessarily believe that there is a God. That you have kind of the concept of nothingness, is where everything came from. And here in the Western part of the world, we kind of have some of the same ideas. At least some scientists do have that same idea that basically, you know, it all started with a Big Bang. You have the Big Bang Theory. Are you familiar with the Big Bang Theory? Okay. Which is the universe just started from, you know, hot, dense state, and then boom, everything just came into place. So, first of all, how old are you?
I am 19.
You're 19? Okay. And did you go, you went to school over in China, right?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, cool. Can I ask, what's your beliefs? Do you have a religion?
Yeah, I am Christian. I'm Baptist.
Okay, you're Baptist.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, but growing up over in China, kind of what's the major beliefs there?
A lot of Chinese people believe in Buddha, but I'm from Myanmar. But in Myanmar, there's a lot of country, and then where I was born is in a little village called Hakka. Most of Hakka people believe in God. Most of them all believe in God, and then they would take Sunday and Saturday off, like anybody would take their off, and then go to church. And then I grew up there, and then I didn't know what God was back then, just because my parents and ancestor and grandparents believed in Jesus Christ. I just go to church too, and then like go to Sunday school, and then like worship him like how my family worship too. But then like after growing up in here, like I went through a lot of things. Like when I get betrayed by my friend, and when my mom left me, and just a lot of things happened to me in life, and it taught me that
your mom left you?
Yeah.
Wow.
It taught me that there's nobody in this world to depend on, and then I realized that Jesus Christ really exists.
Yes.
And then that I also believe I have a purpose to live in this world. And then I feel like my purpose to live in this world is God want me to learn how to count my blessing here.
Mm-hmm.
Through like all this struggle in my life, He want me to learn how to count my blessing and appreciate the thing I have. And then He want me to learn a lot of things in order for me to be with Him, like in next life. And I also believe in next life.
Yeah, that's cool. So what family do you have here now?
Most of people from where I used to born are all like a sibling to me, like a relative to me. Like we all are like that close. If we speak the same language, we all are like family.
Right.
Yeah, I'm close to like all of them, like my community people, like who's in here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So everybody seems like a family to me. There's no stranger here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's cool. Yeah, because I've seen you in here, and you're like the happiest person that in here all the time. So that's cool. Yeah, because I find that interesting. So you weren't really exposed to Buddhist beliefs being in Myanmar?
I don't believe in anything except Jesus Christ, because Buddhists, I saw some Buddhists. I used to have like those Buddhist kids.
Mm-hmm.
Like, to me, any religion is fine to me. Like, I accept any religion. Like, I can have like Buddhist friends, Muslim friends. Like, I'm okay with all of them.
Right.
And then
but you personally believe in
Jesus
Christ.
Christ.
Okay.
But for my belief in Buddhist, I feel like it exists, but it's not for everything. I think it's just a temporary thing that people are like mistaken for. Because like the monk can die, the Buddhist can die from diarrhea or like just some sickness, and he can't come back alive, like
right.
How Jesus Christ did.
Right.
Like he died for us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's my belief too. I remember being in high school. I was so adamant about, you know, my belief in Christ and not having, you know, God said don't have any idols. One of the Ten Commandments, don't have any idols before you. So one of our assignments was to read the book Siddhartha Gautama, which is about Buddhists. Like, I refused to read it. I wouldn't even read it. But then I was curious about it, so I did go home and read it. But I did read it, but what I found was some really interesting things. So what I found was that, you know, Buddha, he was very much concerned about the suffering of people, and actually wanted to get away from, I guess, some of the spoils of life. And so he went out. And you know, he learned, you know, from different shaman and stuff like that. But I don't think Buddha ever actually claimed to be God. You know, he just I think later on began to look at Buddha as though he were God. But I don't think he himself actually claimed to be God. I think people that came later. And so, you know, one of the things I've over the years grown and looked into Christianity and a lot of different religions. You know, I found that if I look at Buddha as God, then that for me as an Israelite and as a person who believes in Christ would be something that's wrong. So what I understand is that Buddha, you know, he did some really great things. He did a lot of things that Christ actually said to do, which was, you know, give alms to other people. And so he did a lot of really great things that actually were in alignment with Christ's teaching. But I think as far as the Buddhist religion, to look at Buddha as God, or it's like, you know, if you look at Genghis Khan or you know, any person there. The Muslims look at Muhammad, you know, as though he were God in the flesh or something like that. And so I think that those types of things are wrong. You know, Buddha was about enlightenment, and I think a lot of people learn about that. I actually had an experience myself that felt like enlightenment. And you know, it was like an explosion in my brain that was spiritual in nature. So you know, there's things to learn from that. But another thing, when I was in college, I used to wonder about the fact that, you know, because I was born in this location in America, in Charlotte, North Carolina, and because of the fact that this is the place where I was born, maybe that's the only reason that I have the beliefs that I have. So I started looking at different things. I looked at Islam. I looked at the Buddhists. I looked at all types of different religions to see, you know, because if I could have been born in India and been, I've forgotten what it is there. Not Buddhism, but something
Hinduism?
Else. Yeah, Hinduism.
Yeah.
Right. You know, I could have been Hindu if I was born there. So how is it that I know that I have the truth? Because I grew up in a Baptist church. So, you know, how do I know that that's true? And so that's why I went and studied all these different things. But what I came back to was, the real truth is in the Bible. Because it's the only place where I can see that there was like actual prophecy where God said to do this. Or he said that this would be, and those things actually came into being.
Yeah.
And then also that he died or whatever, and then came back to life. So have you had any, let's talk about some of the experiences that you had that let you know that God is real?
Oh, well, at first, I would go to church and listen to, like, pastor preaching, and people have devotion about what they go through and then, like, how God is there for them and all this stuff. I would listen, but none of those helped me believe in God. I mean, I know there is God, and then I just accept, I mean, I just accept that Jesus Christ exists, but I don't accept him as my savior. I mean, it's not that I don't accept him, I just don't really care about it. It's just, I call myself Christian, but I don't really do what God really wants me to do. I think most, for me, I can't learn from what people tell me about God, because it will come here and then go back out here. Because most of the time, we live in a world where we care more about social media, friends, going out, and all this and that work. And then some people, like, I will say, oh, okay, I will try to read, I will try to think about what the pastor said the other day. But then I end up looking at my phone, and, like, I never really give time for God.
Yeah.
But then sometimes I thought about it, like, God never forgets to, like, give me food. He never forgets to give me this and that. I mean, why would I forget to tell God thank you to? So I believe we can't study about Jesus Christ. We can't. We have to, like, in order to know that he really exists.
Yeah.
Like, and really accept him. Well, when my mom died, I was in hospital for a month. I was, like, everybody thought I was going to, like, die.
Yeah,
but then, and my leg was broken.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, if I were in Burma, my leg would be all gone. But then God put me here, and then my leg was just a temporary thing. It broke, but I did not die, and then I did not lose my leg.
No.
Like, the doctor fixed that. And I think everything just happened for a reason. God wanted me to live to take care of my sibling and then my dad. I just starting to realize that God really exists. And then I think the only God for me is Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Because I don't believe in Muslim. I don't believe in Muslim Hinduism.
What do you think? Do you think that a lot of people debate about whether or not Jesus was also God? What are your thoughts on that?
Oh, well, God loves us, and he gave us Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus Christ is also a God, because God created Jesus as himself to save us. And then to tell us about things, about preachers, gospel. Yeah, I think he's also God himself, because he's a son of God.
That's
he's also God.
Cool. Yeah, that's huge right there. Because what I kind of realized is that, you know, people didn't, at that time when Jesus was on earth, I call him Yahusha HaMashiach, because in Hebrew that's his name. But people didn't realize at that time that Jesus was what he was trying to tell them when he said before Moses or before Abraham was I am. What he was saying was that I and the Father are one, which is the same thing that God said. He said I am one. So they were both one in mind as well as in spirit. And really, the lesson that I've learned is that is true for everyone. And that's exactly what the Messiah, Jesus, wanted. He wanted people to understand is that we can all be one in Christ. And also that, you know, everyone in the world can be one with the Most High God. And it doesn't matter about race or skin color or any of that, because basically he said anyone who is called by my name, those will be his people. So nothing else really matters, because in the Bible says in Christ we're all one. And so, I have there's a lot of people. I associate with mostly with what's called Hebrew Israelites, and a lot of them are angry because of the African American history, because of slavery, and things like that. But what I found was that in the Bible, it says because our forefathers were disobedient, that was the whole reason for slavery. Because basically the Israelites were kicked out of their homeland, and God said, I'll send you to another nation whose tongue you don't know. And basically he said you'll be punished, until there was almost nothing left. So that's what happened to the African Americans. And we really can't be angry about it, because you know, that's what God said would happen, and that's what took place. That's kind of my argument back to my other Hebrew Israelite brothers, is that you cannot be angry with other individuals, or, you know, with America or Europeans, because of what happened to us, because that happened because of the disobedience of our forefathers. But yeah, I understand what you're saying about basically about there's always distractions or whatever. So, but I, two things I want to say to you is that, you know, don't worry about not always doing, you know, what God wants you to. You know, the Bible says that God has made everything beautiful in His time, and that, so it's kind of a process, you know. But I want you also to know that there's no such thing as death. You know, there's everlasting life. So, you know, as far as your mom, you know, I have personal experience to let me know that there is everlasting life. I lost my great granddaddy to cancer, you know, a long time ago. But God had gave me experiences where He allowed me to connect to both my great grandmother as well as my great granddaddy, you know, in the afterlife. And so I know that there's, you know, one of God's names is El Olam, which means the everlasting God. And so, you know, even in death, you know, God is able to keep us. King David said, though my flesh decay and then my bones turn to dust, he said, yet in my flesh will I see God. Because he also knew that, you know, there's no such thing as death. And, you know, the dry bones, there's a parable about, you know, the dry bones in the valley and then coming back to life, which, you know, God wanted to tell his people that, that basically he's able to do all things. Like, if he can make a burning bush not be a bush being consumed by fire, but not being consumed by the fire, or if he could spread the waters on the Red Sea, he can do all things, so he can keep us even after we die.
So. I mean, I don't know. I just, when I lost my mother or lost my friend, like, not to death, but like lost my friend, like one time we were just so close, and then I lost it to, like, when they get something better or have a better friend, they just left. I mean, I just think I can't depend on anybody in life, and then that nobody will love me like how Jesus Christ, God will love me, and then people will love me for what I have maybe, and then what I get or what I can do, and then like, and what I am. I mean, and God loved me for, not because of those things, but for who I am.
Yeah.
And then that's the reason why, like, I believe in Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And then I believe in God. I believe in Christianity.
Well, that part is certainly true. You know, you certainly, there's nobody that can love you the way that God does.
Yeah.
And for me, that over the years, it took some time, because I used to go to church, but I was really hungry for the word for some reason. That's always been, like, I guess, the calling on my life or whatever. And I didn't want it. Because, like, growing up, to be honest, is like everybody in my family was like, oh, you're going to be a preacher. And I was like, man, black people always got to be preachers. Like, why? Like, why we always got to be preachers? And so I was like, can I be something else? So I was like so adamant about, like, dang, I want to do something else. So I was like, no, I'm just going to be an engineer. But really, I really can't get away from it, because, like, God just kind of pulled me in, like, no, I need you, you know, to do this. And so, like, if God wants you, He's gonna have you. And so, certainly, there's nobody that can love you the way that God does.
Yeah.
I call God's name Yahuwah, because That's the name that he gave Moses, the Yod Hey Wahe. That's in Hebrew. In English, it's YHWH. I pronounce it Yahuwah. Nobody's really certain of the pronunciation, but that's the best one that I know. But the thing is that you go through certain sufferings or whatever, but actually, you know, God will bring the right people into your life. And what I found is that there's no coincidences. I used to have experiences. I'm like, oh man, that's a coincidence. But what I found out is definitely no coincidence, because I've had other experiences to let me know. I mean, there was no explanation for certain things that I've seen. I've seen things before time, before they happen. One example, just a small example. I was about maybe 10. I was at a bus stop and kind of had like a premonition. I was with my aunt and I was with her best friend, and I grabbed my aunt's best friend, pulled her out of the street because I could see ahead of time that there was a car getting ready to come down the road, that if I hadn't pulled her out of the way, she would have been hit by the car. So it's stuff like that. And it's been many other situations where God has been acting on me. And so, you know, even though you go through certain trials and tribulations or whatever, like those things over time will help you. You'll learn from them, and you just grow stronger. So is there any question that you have that maybe I could answer?
I used to have a question about, like, I used to have a lot of questions, but then I get answered about Crusade. Like, I went to Crusade sometime. Like, my church will, like, call somebody, like, a professional, I guess, from, like, another country, and they will come. I used to have questions, like, I mean, everybody is racist. A lot of people are racist in here, but even Christian people, they will be like, oh, don't hang out with that bad guy because he's a bad guy. He's a drug dealer.
Right.
I mean, to me, there's no stranger or color different in my life, and I would question myself, why would Christian people, like, you're so racist about color or who we hang out with? Why can't we all just like be at peace?
Yes.
And then who we call sinner? We all are sinner. Like, we all sin. Like, even a pastor sin. Even like everybody sin. Like, so God don't want us to sin, but we all sin. Do we all go to hell? Like, even a baby who is born, he's a sin. And then like some women would do abortion about their kids. Like, and then the baby from who was born yesterday would die, and she was a sinner. Like, how do we go to heaven? That's what I was thinking.
Yeah.
And then one of the pastors told me that we were all saved by Jesus Christ. We were all a sinner by Adam and Eve, whatever they did with the apple, or like not listening to God.
Right.
We all are a sinner. And then from the Old Testament, and the New Testament became was written after Jesus Christ died for us. He should, like, before. When someone did a sin, they used animal blood to repent.
Yes.
But Jesus
it was something
Christ,
they had to do repeatedly.
Yeah. And then so after that, Jesus Christ died for us. And then these new generation, new people, new us, he told me that we all are saved by Jesus Christ already.
Mm-hmm.
And then that a baby who was born yesterday, and if the baby died, the baby will go to heaven, because
right.
We only sin after we know the bad and good and still chose to do it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right. So sin, the word sin means, breaking the law, basically, or falling away, or to fall short of the law. The reason that with Adam and Eve, how the way sin came into the world was because they broke the law. They broke the commandment, and it started out really simple. You know, God had them this one commandment, which was, listen, don't eat of the tree that's in the midst of the garden. So he's like, everything else that's around the garden, you can eat, but that tree that's in the midst, which is the tree of life, don't eat of it, because he didn't really give a reason. He just said, don't eat of it. That was the one commandment they had. So it was really simple for them to be able to stay in paradise. They only had to do one thing, which not eat. And God was actually able to come down and be among them. He could be face to face with them as long as they didn't sin. So then in came the serpent, and he actually didn't lie. He deceived them. He told them, you won't die if you eat it. If you eat, he said, but you will, if you eat of this tree, you become, it wasn't tree of food, it was the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. But when they ate of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, which was forbidden for them, the way that they became knowledgeable of good and evil was because they broke the commandment of God. They broke the law of God, and which is evil. And so just in eating the fruit, they broke the law of God, and they became knowledgeable. It's like they became knowledgeable of their nakedness. They became aware of lust and sinfulness in their flesh, and that's what made them die, because being apart from God is a spiritual death, but also they also began to die in their flesh as well. So he did tell them the truth that you'll become knowledgeable of good and evil like God, but they didn't have to eat the fruit to become like God, because they were already like God. Because God said in the beginning he created them in his image and after his likeness. So then things became way more complicated. We got the ten commandments, or actually 600 some commandments, and so it became even more difficult to keep the law. So then Jesus came and took on all that sin and all that suffering for us. So we have to believe in him, but we also have to go back and keep the laws and the statutes and the commandments of God, because Jesus said, that is what is the love for God, is obedience to him. So some people say you just have to believe in Christ, that he was and that he died on the cross, but you also have to keep the commandments as well. So that's my belief. So you probably gotta go.
Yeah, we have a couple minutes left.
Okay, all right, well, thank you for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.